Tootsie's Orchid Lounge rose to fame as the unofficial watering hole of the stars. Just a few paces outside the back door of the Ryman Auditorium, many Opry legends walked that alley to the back door of Tootsie's before and after their sets at the Ryman. Today, the famed establishment is celebrating 50 years of business with a party like none other. Kelly Lynn caught up with a few of the special guests on the red carpet before a show at the Ryman and an after party right down the alley at Tootsie's.
Opry legend, Little Jimmy Dickens. How are you tonight?
Whatever old people do, that's what I do.
Okay. Well, that's cool. Now, do you have any stories for me? Because I know many nights you have got off the Opry down at the Ryman and stepped over to Tootsie's. Are there any really interesting stories that you remember?
Well, nothing in particular, because that's what we all did. The whole cast of the Grand Ole Opry, between times for you to go on stage and do your thing, and then when you had your break, you come to Tootsie's because you knew you'd meet your friends there.
Being raised at the Ryman Auditorium, when my father, George Morgan, thought I was up in the balconies watching the show, I, of course, snuck across the street to the back door of Tootsie's, and I think I'm probably one of the only artists that are here tonight that have a key, a purple key, to the back door of Tootsie's. Where I can go in anytime I want, and so I'm glad to be celebrating. This is a great night.
I am here with Cadillac Man himself, Mr. Randy Hauser. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I am so good. It's so good to see you. Now tell me a little bit about tonight and what it means to you to come back and give back to Tootsie's.
Well, you know, I mean, obviously, you know, Kelly, we've known each other a long time, and you know how many times I've run down this stretch of bars and hung out, and Tootsie's has always made me feel at home. It's always felt like a place I could hang my hat, and if I want to come hang out and drink, I can do that. If I want, you know, we're talking about 2 o'clock in the afternoon a lot of days. Whenever, if we're not riding, just come down here and hear some country music, because Tootsie's is also one of the last places you can hear real authentic country music, and so I really love that. And I can come down here and hang out. If I want to get up and play, I can. If I don't want to, nobody gives you no pressure.
I think Tootsie's is such a huge part of who I am as an artist and my story and my career and my personality now, that I can't see how anything could have wound up the way it did without me walking through the door that day.
I'm here with the owners of Tootsie Lounge, Mr. Steve Smith and Al Ross. How are you guys doing?
We're doing great.
This is a wonderful event. Talk a little bit about the planning and when you guys came up with the idea to celebrate your 50 years here and do this big shebang tonight.
Yeah, I got to turn that over to Steve. This was, he's been planning this for years in his mind, and it's just now come to fruition. But I'd say he's been planning it. How long have you been planning it, Val?
Well, actually, it slipped up on me. I've been playing it for about 2 years, and we went to work on it a year ago, and started off with it. We didn't know where it was going to go, and we started talking about what artists we did invite. Next thing you know, all the artists started dominoing and said, we want to be involved, and that's how it all came about. If it wasn't for the artists of country music support Tootsie's Orchid Lounge, it wouldn't be no Tootsie's Orchid Lounge.
I've been hanging out at Tootsie's since the 80s, when I first started coming to Nashville. I grew up hearing all the stories about Tootsie's and how the stars used to go across the alley and go have a drink or two at Tootsie's between their sets. So the first thing I wanted to do was see the alley, you know. And so, you know, before I had a record deal and I could sing at the Opry, I was hanging out there. And then the very first time I sang at the Opry when it was at Ryman, that's the only reason I wanted to do it, so I could sneak across the alley, so I could contribute to that legend.
Do you have any good intimate stories about Tootsie's, maybe a night that you were just out on the town?
I can tell you a really good story. John Stone, who's played in there a lot and been a part of Tootsie's for a while, I stopped in there one night, and I was looking at that stage, and I'm going, it ain't very big, and I'm a pretty good-sized boy. And then I was looking at the ledge to step up there, and I didn't see the stair, and I'm thinking, man, I don't know if I can reach I'm kind of short. And I'd made up my mind I was going to fall, and by God, I went to jump up there, and I fell, and I'm talking about there's keyboards flying and guitars going. I'm just glad that ain't on camera somewhere.
What's probably the most loved song that you just have to do every night to get them going?
Well, every single place I go, and I've played in different parts of the world, you can hit the first 8 notes of Sweet Home Alabama, and everybody just loses their mind.
All right.
Everywhere. It don't even matter if they can speak the language. They know that song.
Now, you were around in the beginning of Tootsie Days, so you probably know Miss Tootsie Tootsie Bess? And
oh, I knew her so well. I just saw one of her son, her stepson, out there a while ago, old Jarko. I hadn't seen old Jarko in years, but he was out there. But, oh, yeah, the Tootsies, it used to be Mom's. See, I was here before Tootsies, and she bought it from Mom. Daddy called Mom, and all of us kids used to, kids out there, all of us would-be singers and songwriters would hang out there, and we'd write our songs. And then but later on, here comes Willie Nelson and Hank Cochran and William Jennings and Bill Anderson, all the great songwriters. You know, we'd gather up there and play each other of our songs, and I really liked it back in those days. There was a lot of respect for each other.
Were you discovered, would you say, at Tootsie's?
I would say so. You know, that was where I was always performing, and so whenever I came to the attention of my record label that I'm at now, Columbia, they would send their A&R reps out to see me play at Tootsie's. So it's been a neat experience. And as far as the celebrities at Tootsie's, I always seem to miss the big ones, because one night I left and Cher came in and I totally missed her.
Now it's time for our weekly songwriter tip, brought to you by Nashville Songwriters Association International. NSAI is a key resource for any songwriter, either an established star or someone just getting started. This week we sit down with James Dean Hicks as he tells us why it's important to keep an open mind when writing.
One thing that I've learned in songwriting is no matter how many hits you've had or how few hits you've had, check your ego at the door. When you walk into a writing room, the only thing that matters is that song. And when you start to write and you feel like this has to be my line, or it has to go this way, or the melody has to go this way, make sure that if you're co-writing that you check your ego at the door, because the only thing that matters is what is good for that song. And when you start to get away from that and you start to interject yourself and just because you feel like I gotta be in there, that can really hurt your song.
Check out NashvilleSongwriters.com for more information on NSAI. That's about all the time we have for this week's show. Don't forget those special gift packs we have up for grabs. We've got new music from Sugarland, Easton Corbin, Billy Currington, and Jamie Johnson. If you want to enter this week's drawing for a wonderful stocking stuffer, you have to email me your mailing address. That's Bailey@InsideMusicRow.com. Now, if you want to get Inside Music Row on your mobile phone for the best in country music at your fingertips, just go to TrueCountry.tv and get the True Country channel. We're going to leave you today with Sugarland and their latest hit, Stuck Like Glue. Until next time, I'm Bailey for Inside Music Row, and I'll see you again real soon.
There you go, making my heart beat again. There you go, making me feel like a kid. Won't you do it and do it one time? There you go, pulling me right back in. And I know I'm never letting this go. I'm stuck on you. Stuck like glue, you and me, baby, we're stuck like glue. Whoa, whoa, stuck like glue, you and me, baby, we're stuck like glue.